Hello dear students and welcome to this online class video. This is the second part of the fifth chapter, Does It Look the Same, of class 5 subject mathematics. Let's start the class. Now come to the today's overview. So we have only one topic for today's class, that is half a turn. So let's know that what is half a turn. So I am writing a letter, that is T. Okay, so if you will take a half turn of this letter, means from up to down, if you take a rotation, so how it will look? Yeah, it will look like this. Okay, then if you will take another turn of this half turn, so you will get its previous picture, that is T. So this turn is known as half a turn. Clear? Means you can say upside down, that you have studied in class 4. You can also say this is upside down. Now come to the today's topic, that is half a turn. So here we have a very interesting story of a king. So let's know that what is happening in this story. Okay, so I am going to read this story first. Once there was a king. He was upset because thieves kept stealing costly jewels from his locker. So here you can see the king has a locker, but he was very upset. Why? Because these thieves always stealing the jewels. Now here is what the locker is looked like. So I have already shown you this picture. Now next is, the locker could be opened by giving its handle half a turn. So here was the idea, that how the locker was opening. So if the locker is given half a turn, so it will be open. Then another half turn, then the locker will be again locked. So it's very confusing that if you will take half turn of this locker, so it will be open. Okay, half turn means up to down, then it will be open. Then if you will take another half turn, so it will be now closed. So how you will know that, by looking the picture, how you will know that the locker is open or closed? Yeah, it is very confusing. So here, by looking the picture, we can't say that this is open or this is closed, or means this is locked, because there is no idea that, there is no identification in this locker, that how can we identify that is open or this is locked. So let's know further in this story. Now the king would often leave the locker open thinking it was locked. Can you guess the reason? Yes, we have already discussed about that there is no identification in this locker, that in which condition this is locked and this is unlocked. So sometimes the king also opened the locker and just left. Then next, here is the picture of open and locked locker. So you can see both are looking same, for that everyone may be confused. Similarly, the king was already confused that this is open or locked. Now next, what is happening in this story? One day his clever daughter gave him an idea which he liked very much. So let's know what is the idea of her daughter. Now he never got confused. Can you guess what the idea was? Yes, we can guess. Here you can see the pictures of the locker. Here on the yellow shape, you can see we have a black dot. It means it is open, and in locked, the black dot is downside. Here it is upside and here it is downside. So now we can easily say that the locker is open or locked by looking the locker. Now the king's daughter asked the question to put a dot on one of the yellow blades. So yes, you can see in the yellow blades there are dots. If the dot is upside, it means that is open, and if the dot is downside, it means that is locked. So it was very nice idea by her daughter. Now come to the next. The king had many such lockers with different handles. Check if on giving them half a turn, he can get confused with this too. So here are some more pictures of the lockers, and you can see it is also similar to the previous one. So we can't say that this is open or this is locked, because there is no identification. So similarly for the means like the previous picture, we have to put a dot on this blades. So we can say that it is lock or unlock. Now next, what will you do to solve the problem for each of these? Same thing we will do that the king's daughter has done. Now here is same after half turn. So dear students, you have already known that what is half turn. So here we have to find the half turn of this picture. So let's read the question first. Guess which of the shapes below would look the same after a half turn. So in these pictures we have to find that which pictures are will be look same if we will give a half turn. So come to the first picture, it is a square. Okay, so half turn means upside down, means half rotation. Remember that if we will give a half rotation, so it will be a half turn. So first is square. So yes, if you will give a half turn, it will look like the same. Now come to the second, it is a rectangle. So what will happen if you will give a half turn? It will look like the same as its original picture. Yes, it will look like the same. Now we have a circle. Yes, it will be shown. Now we have a rectangle. So yes, it will be also look like the same if we will give a half turn. Here we have a triangle. So if you will give a half turn to this triangle, so how it will look? Let me draw its picture. Yeah, it will look like this. So the original picture and the half turn picture is not looking same. So it is not. Now we have a next picture. So yes, it will look like the same if you will give a half turn. And last we have a pentagon. So how it will look in half turn? Let me draw the picture for it. Yeah, I am trying to make a picture. Yeah, it will look like this. So it is just opposite of this original picture. So it is not. So these two, means this triangle and this pentagon, are not looking as its original picture after giving the half turn. Now come to the next page, page number 79. So here we have a question that do you find it difficult to tell? No, we do not find any difficult to tell. If yes, then there is a way to check your guess. Here is how you can do it. So here is an activity to find its half turn if you face difficulties on previous question. So let's have a reading of this. Take any of the shapes, trace its outline on a sheet paper. As you can see, as a paper the girl is taken, then she is tracing it outline. Now and give it a half turn. So in the last picture, in the third picture, you can see the girl is given half turn. See if the shape it fit its outline. So it is just a practical activity. You can do it at your home if you are confused on half turn. Now next is practice time. So here are some questions for our practice. So come to the first question. Find out which letters in English alphabet look the same after a half turn. So in English alphabet we have 26 letters. So we one by one we have to check the all letters. Okay, and we have to find that after giving half turn, which letters are looking like the same. Now come to the A first. So here it is A. So give its half turn. So how it will look? It will look like this. Yes. Okay. So are they same? No, they are not same. Now come to the next letter, that is B. Yeah, I have written B. So in half turn, how it will look? It will look like this. So both are not same. So in this way you can check the all alphabetical letters. So let me tell you the letters which are same if we will give them half a turn. So the first letter is H. You can try by writing its half turn. Second is I. Next is N. Another one is O. Next is S. And next we have X letter. And at last Z. So these are the letters which are look like the same as its original if we will give them a half turn. You can make its half turn. Next we have second question. Which of these English words reads the same on half a turn? So we have our seven letters. Okay, so if in these words we have that seven letter, so it will be look like same as its half tone. So come to the first, which is zoom. So Z O O are looking like same if we will give them a half tone, but M is not. So for that, it will be not a same picture. Now second is M O W. So if you will write M O W in half a tone, so it will be look like same. Similarly, swings S W I M S, it will be same. S I S, yes, it will be same. And also noon is look like same. But only zoom will not show. So how it will be look? Let me write this. It will look like this. W then double O then Z. So it is looking like this. O's. And here it is written zoom. So for that, the first picture was not. Then the others are looking like same. Now third question we have. Give a half turn to the numbers from 0 to 9. Okay. Find which of them is still look like the same. So first we have to find their half turns. So let me write the numbers from 0 to 9 here. So first we have write here 0, then 1, 2, 3, then 4. Then here I have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now we are going to make their half turns. So this is 0. So how it will look? It will look like the same as 0. Then second we have 1. Yes, it is the opposite. Then 2 we have. So 2 will look like this. Then 3, like this it will look. Then 4, 4 will look like this. Then we have 5. So 5 is how it will look? It will be look like this. This one. Then 6 will look like just 9. 7, 8. 8 will be look like same. You can see here. Wait a minute. Let me make its half turn. Then 9. Yeah, it will look like this. So here you have half turn pictures of the numbers from 0 to 9. So here you can identify that 0, 1 and at last 8. Means 0, 1 and 8. These three digits are look like the same as its half turns. So we can say from 0 to 9, 0, 1 and 8 are looking like same in its half turn. Now come to the next question. The next question is question number 4. Think of all 2, 3 and 4 digit numbers which look the same on half turn. So for some examples are given here. Here are 2 digit numbers 11. So dear students, you have to note it that from 0 to 9 we have 0, 1 and 8. These three we have the digits which are looking like the same in its half turn. So only these numbers you can make the half, means the same number you can make. So 11 is given here. Now second we can make 88. Okay, these two numbers we can make only. Then come to the three digit number. Remember that you will use only 0, 1 and 8 to make the half turn numbers. So 101 is written here, 111 is written here. Now from the 8 you can make some numbers. So you can write 888, means triple 8, 888. Second you can use, second you can make the number by using 8 and 0. So 8, write 8, then 0, then 8. 808 you can write and write there. Then the next number you will make using 8, 1 and 8. So that will be 818. Then at last you can make 181, means 181. So these are the numbers that will look like the same in its half turn. Then come to the next, that is a 4 digit number. So first we have 1001, second we have 1111. So now we will use 8 and 1. So what numbers we are finding? Let's know this. So first number we will use, we will make, that will be 8008. Let me write once again, 8008. Then the second number we will use by writing all the numbers 888, means 8888. Then the second we can make 8118, means 8118. Then last number we will make 1881. So these are the numbers which will look like the same in its half term. Now in the next page we have our next question. The question is, which among the following pictures will look the same on half a turn? So we have six pictures here. So which will look the same on its half turn? So it's very easy. Come to the first picture. So if you will make its half turn, means first make its half. Okay. So it will be its half turn. So all sides are have the same type of design. So the first one is the answer. Second, if you will divide this picture in half, so you can see that it is not equal and its half turn will not look like the same. Third will be look like the same. P, if you will write P in opposite direction, so how it will look? It will look like this. So it is not. This arrow, yeah, it will be not, because if you will make its half turn, so it will look like this. So it will be not the same. And the last one is also look like the same in its half turn. Now we have two more pictures. Yeah, here we have a triangular design. So triangular designs are not look like the same in its half turn. In previous pictures we have solved this. And here the last one is will look like the same in its half turn. Now an activity is here. So let's know this activity. Have you ever seen a windmill? Yes, you have seen windmills. Where? Yes, on the sea beaches you have seen, in the mountain area you have seen that. What is it's used for? Actually, it's uses to produce energy, means electricity. Let us make a toy windmill. So the girl is having a toy windmill. So how to make it? Here are some steps. You can read it very well. And I think you have made this type of windmill in your previous classes also. So some steps are here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, 8 steps are given here. So some questions are here. So let's know this first. Does your windmill look the same on 1/4 turn? So dear friends, in previous pages we studied about half turn. Okay, means half turn means you will rotate the picture half, but here we have 1/4 turn. So what is 1/4 turn? To understand this, look at this picture. Okay, if you will divide this picture, okay, so its half will look like same. Now if you will divide it horizontally, so you will see that 1, 2, 3, and 4 parts we have. So each part is known as its 1/4 turn. Clear? Okay. So this is one part is known as its 1/4 turn. Remember this. So now you have to answer that in 1/4 turn it will look like the same. So how you can say? You have to understand that this picture is equal in all four sides. So if a picture is equal and looking like same with color and size, so in 1/4 turn that picture will look like the same. So here you can write and the answer in yes. Now second, does it look like the same on a half turn? Yes, we have already discussed about it, that in half turn it will look like the same. So in this way we have understand the half turn, you can say 1/2 turn, through the pictures and through a story. I hope that you have very well understanding about it. And now I have to over this class. See you all in the next video very soon. And at last I want to say bye-bye.